Hey, space friends, this week I'm talking about surprising evolutionary quirks. This is a bit of a silly episode, but something that's always tickled me, and so I wanted to share it with all of you. A few years ago, I was in South Africa, and I saw these adorable little creatures called rock hyraxes. They're also known as rock badgers or rock rabbits, but these rock hyraxes are really fascinating because, well, I mean, they're really adorable first. Let's talk about how adorable they are. They look like little rodents or hamsters or guinea pigs, but they're not little at all. They're the size of cats. If anything, they have sort of these cute little round ears, and they just look like something that would be in a Star Wars film. They also are like cats more than just in their size, but also they love sunbathing. So to me, they're like these furry little weird cats that run around in South Africa and other parts of Africa and the Middle East. The surprising evolutionary quirk that I learned about them, though, when I got home and looked up more about them, was that supposedly their closest relative is the elephant. Yeah, these furry little critters, supposedly their closest relative is an elephant. When I first read that on Wikipedia, I thought, well, surely this is Wikipedia and some scientist or something is having fun trolling everyone, telling that rock hyraxes are related to elephants. But the more I looked into it, the more I realized it wasn't just Wikipedia trolling. There is actually some truth to this. It's still considered a bit debated, but there's a lot of facts that point towards the fact that rock hyraxes might indeed be closely related to elephants, closely on a relatively speaking term. And by relatively speaking term, I mean 60 million years ago. So it's thought that rock hyraxes and elephants had a common ancestor and they maybe diverged around 60 million years ago. If you're up to date on dinosaur timelines, that means the big asteroid that was thought to hit around 65 million years ago, famously, this happened a bit after that. Again, relatively speaking, we're talking a few million years of difference, but you know, what's a few million years between friends? Manatees are also thought to be close relatives of the elephant, but a lot of people don't have as many issues trying to figure out how a manatee and an elephant are related as they do a rock hyrax and an elephant. Rock hyraxes are cute, and elephants are cute too, but not so much on the fluffy side and not so small either. So how are these two related, and what are the facts pointing to the fact that they likely are? Well, for starters, they look at their teeth. Rock hyraxes and elephants both have tusks. So rock hyraxes, even though they don't have as impressive of tusks as elephants, they have little tusks in their mouths that emanate out from the same area that elephants have tusks. They also have flat toenails. So the way that elephants have sort of these flat toenails on their toes, rock hyraxes have that too. With one specific exception, they have these grooming nails on one of their back feet that help them, well, groom. That's a pretty handy evolutionary advantage, I would say, over an elephant. Although elephants, you know, have some pretty awesome things too. Elephants are one of my favorite animals, and I should probably do an episode just talking about my favorite animals because, I mean, it's my own YouTube channel, why not? The similarities don't stop there because rock hyraxes and elephants are related to each other in a lot of other weird ways. Most interestingly, their reproductive organs. I'm not going to go into a whole lot of detail about their reproductive organs and what they have similar and what they don't. I'm going to put more of that information in the YouTube description below. But there are things like, well, they don't have scrotums, their testicles are inside, and I don't know, other things that maybe I shouldn't be going too much into detail about and you can just research for yourself. Other things that elephants and rock hyraxes have in common is they both have a large hippocampus area. So they both are really smart, known for good memory, and lead very social lives, which is just really adorable to think about. Elephants are already fascinating for just how caring of creatures that they can be, and rock hyraxes live incredibly social lives with large families where they all talk to each other quite regularly. So yeah, ever since I learned about rock hyraxes being these cute, adorable, fluffy things being related to elephants, which are large, still adorable things, but they seem so different, but they have so many weird similarities in reproductive organs and toenails and all sorts of stuff, like being really social and good at memory games and all things like that. I don't know, I really enjoyed learning about this and I haven't been able to really shake this fact out of my head. So I actually wanted to hear from all of you what weird evolutionary things you've picked up over the years that always weirded you out or surprised you, or you thought were just fascinating because they were kind of unexpected. Go ahead and leave a comment and I will read through all of them. Looking forward to learning some new things from all of you. Otherwise, I'll see you all next week. And as always, if you're enjoying these videos, please head on over to my Patreon campaign and sign up there. You can get cool stuff and geek out with me about things week to week.